I think democracy is the most revolutionary thing in the world, far more revolutionary than socialist ideas or anybody else's idea, because if you have power, you use it to meet the needs of you and your community. And this idea of choice, which Capital talks about all the time, you've got to have a choice. Choice depends on the freedom to choose. And if you're shackled with debt, you don't have a freedom to choose.
It seems like it benefits the system if the average working person is shackled
with
debt.
Yes, and people in debt become hopeless, and hopeless people don't vote. See, they always say everyone should vote, but I think if the poor in Britain or the United States turned out and voted for people who represented their interests, it would be a real democratic revolution. And so they don't want it to happen. So keeping people hopeless and pessimistic. See, I think there are two ways in which people are controlled. First of all, frighten people, and secondly, demoralize them. An educated, healthy, and confident nation is harder to govern. And I think there's an element in the thinking of some people. We don't want people to be educated, healthy, and confident because they would get out of control. The top 1% of the world's population own 80% of the world's wealth. It's incredible that people put up with it, but they're poor, they're demoralized, they're frightened, and therefore they think perhaps the safest thing to do is take orders and hope for the best.
Here, my kids, they're sure that they're going to get, you know, a certain level of care, a certain education. College, I don't have to worry about.
No, university education. They don't pay for it.
You're kidding. Nothing?
You can get a college education for free.
No way.
Yes.
There's not a sense of desperation.
And keep them
right.
That's the worst part.
Right. They rest, they enjoy.
And they're happy.
And they're able to spend time with their kids. So, you know, the vacations, there's family time.
So how many weeks of paid vacation?
Minimum 5 weeks.
5 weeks?
Minimum of
5 weeks.
That's the French law.
Unless you work for a large company, you get sometimes 8, 10 weeks.
Remembering that there is a 35-hour week.
Productivity rate is so high here.
Yeah, I read that it was higher than the United States.
Yeah, they're relaxed.
If they're working more than 35 hours a week, they'll get extra days off.
And are there
part-time and full-time employees as well?
You get 5 weeks paid vacation even if you're a part-time employee?
Everybody. You get married, the year you get married, you get like an extra week or an extra 7 days for your honeymoon. In addition to your 5 weeks.
You're paid to take your honeymoon.
Correct. So I don't know.
You want to move to France now?
Yeah, if you move.
You mean if you're going to move from one apartment to another?
Yeah. One day.
You get a day to move, and they pay you that day.
These are the laws here.
When my daughter was 3 months old, there was this free service that will send somebody to your home to give you tips on what to do with your child, how to get them to sleep every single day for free.
And they'll come to your house and do your laundry.
They will.
No! Stop! Stop!
When you have a baby.
One of the things that keeps everything running here is that the government is afraid of the people. They're afraid of protests. They're afraid of reactions from the people. Whereas in the States, people are afraid of the government. They're afraid of acting up. They're afraid of protesting. Mm-hmm. They're afraid of getting out. In France, that's what people do.
Au contraire, au moins 160 000 jeunes, selon la police, ont défilé cet après-midi.
À Bordeaux, plus de 2 000 personnes ont manifesté pour l'emploi, le maintien des services publics.
De conditions de travail qui se détériorent.
Aujourd'hui, on veut normalement être connu au travers d'une loi, comme quoi notre profession est dangereuse.
A choisi comme slogan, touche pas à mon jour férié.
De lundi Pentecôte. C'était le travail obligatoire du lundi Pentecôte. Ça ne passe pas.
Je t'aime. Je t'aime. Oui, je t'aime.
After seeing all this, I began to wonder, was there a reason our government and our media wants us to hate the French? Are they worried we might like the French? Or like their ways of doing things?
All in this one block?
Normalmente en la mayoría de las cuadras es así, farmacia, hay un hospital cerca.
All right, thank you very much. Thank you.
Okay, okay, I know what you're thinking. Cuba is where Lucifer lives. The worst place on Earth. The most evil nation ever created. How do we know that? Because that's what we've been told for over 45 years.
That a series of offensive missile sites can be none other than to provide a nuclear strike capability against the Western Hemisphere.
I'm not going to yield until Fidel Castro allows freedom on the island. That's it. See? You can count on it. Put it in the bank.
It seems that what really bugged us about Castro was that he overthrew the dictator that we liked and replaced him with a dictator that we didn't like, himself. And so now, after all these years, the one thing the Cubans do have is free universal health care. They've become known around the world as having not only one of the best health care systems, but as being one of the most generous countries in providing doctors and medical equipment to third world countries. In the U.S., healthcare costs run nearly $6,000 per person, but in Cuba, they spend only $251.
Cuba es una pequeña islita del Caribe con muy pocos recursos. Se puede hacer mucho por la salud del ser humano. Y eso no ocurre en Estados Unidos de Norteamérica. ¿Por qué nosotros podemos y ustedes no? Ahí sí tendríamos que darnos cuenta, porque un país, mientras más produce, mientras más riquezas tiene, puede cuidar mejor a su gente.